Assalamualaikum and good morning. So today we're going to talk about the movement across plasma membrane for this topic. So let's discuss about it together. So first one, we got isotonic, the second one is hypotonic, and the third one is hypertonic. Let's we see the effect on plant. For the hypotonic, it will plasmolysis. For hypotonic, it will turgid. For isotonic, it will turn to flaccid. How about the effect on animal? So for isotonic, it will stay normal. For hypotonic, it will lysis. For hypertonic, it will crenation. Let's we talk about phospholipid. We got hydrophobic, which is repel water. Hydrophilic is attract water, which is nonpolar, fatty acid, and glycerol. Active energy and passive energy. Active need energy, passive no need. Accumulation is occurs again concentration of gradient. Osmosis need water, diffusion simple facilitated.
Hi, so today I'll be telling you about the subtopic 11.2. Actions of antibodies. First off, we got agglutination, in which antibodies coagulate the pathogens and make them an easy target to be trapped and destroyed by phagocytes. The second one is neutralization. In this process, the antibodies will bind with toxins produced by bacteria and neutralize the toxin. The third one is precipitation. The antibodies react with dissolved antigens to form an insoluble complex that is easily destroyed by phagocytes. After that, we got opsonization. The antibodies combine with antigens and act as a marker for phagocytes to recognize the antigens and destroy them. Lastly, we have lysis, in which the antibodies combine with antigens and cause bacteria to be broken down and decomposed. That's all from me, thank you.
Carbohydrate. Carbohydrate is an organic compound that contain carbon elements. There are three main types of carbohydrate, which are monosaccharide, disaccharide, and polysaccharide. Monosaccharide is the simple sugar, and most monosaccharide taste sweet and form crystal and dissolve in water. Example of monosaccharide is like glucose, fructose, and galactose. Monosaccharide has the reducing power, which is the ability to transfer hydrogen or electron to other compound. And next is about disaccharide. Disaccharide molecules are formed when two simple sugar molecule monosaccharide combine through condensation to form a disaccharide. And at the same time, disaccharide can also be broken down to their monosaccharide unit through hydrolysis and the addition of the one water molecule. Example of disaccharide include sucrose, maltose, and lactose. And lastly is about the polysaccharide. Polysaccharide similar to disaccharide and form through the condensation process and involve hundreds of monosaccharide to form long molecular chain. And polysaccharide can also be disintegrated through hydrolysis with the help of dilute acid, boiling, and enzyme action. And example of polysaccharide is like cellulose, starch, and glycogen.
Transports in plants. First of all, what is the necessity of transport in plants? Plants are multicellular organisms which are formed from cells that need water and nutrients. The large and tall size of plants creates a total surface area that is insufficient for the plant to absorb its basic needs from the surroundings. In order to overcome this problem, plants have vascular tissues to transport water, mineral salts, and nutrients to all the cells. There are two types of vascular tissues. Xylem transports water and mineral salts absorbed by the roots to the stems and leaves. Phloem transports organic compounds which are synthesized by the leaves through photosynthesis to the stems and roots. Transports of water and mineral salts. Transpirational pool produced when water that is evaporated from the stomach pulls water from the leaves. Capillary action. Capillary action is produced from adhesion force and cohesion force of water molecules, which move water upwards in the stem against gravity.
growth pressure.